My grandmother told me that it's just that's a lump of flesh, you know, which is known as haram ki boti, and you're not supposed to have that in you. I was 7 years old one day when my grandmother came to my home, and she asked me to join her in a huge gathering, and she told me that there would be a lot of children like me and I could befriend them and I would play with them. So I was very excited, you know. When I climbed to first floor, I saw there was no one, so just a lady. So we sat for a while, we sat for like an hour, and then another lady came and she took us to upstairs. There was one small room. It was so small, it was dark, it was messy. I still remember I was sitting on the bed, and the other lady, she was taking a rough cloth and a blade and from the drawer. I was too young to actually, you know, not to trust my grandmother. Next thing happened that gave me a shock. They actually made me lie down, and then they held my hands and legs, and the other lady, she spread my legs, and then she pulled down the underwear, and then she grabbed that blade and cut something between my legs. I was rebelling at that time, was screaming that what is happening to me? That pain was intolerable, seriously. I still feel that. I was still crying at that time. They were all laughing and congratulating each other that now she is being circumcised.
Tradition is it's a practice that has come in from Africa, because there were the missionaries who came in from Egypt and Yemen into India, and they came into Gujarat, and that's where they started converting the traders into Bohras. Bohras were trading communities, so men used to go out for work. They used to be away from home for a long period of time, so that the wife or the woman in the house, she's faithful, remains faithful, so her sexual urges are curbed. My grandmother, this particular day, she told me, we're going to Bhendi Bazaar. I've taken to this building, a most dilapidated, nondescript building. And in this building, I see, I've been taken to a second floor house, which is a very small, dingy place. She makes us sit for a while, and then after a little bit of conversation, she kind of, says, pull your trousers down, and I am just wondering what is happening. Before one could even think and realize, there is somebody holding your legs and somebody holding your hands, and there is this lady on you, kind of thing, and the act happens. Today, when I sometimes go through that, I do feel the trauma and the pain that I experienced that day.
I remember that house, you know, and that lady, some thing about her face, and then I was asked to lie down, and the story is very similar.
It definitely physically and psychologically impacts you, and it is there in your memory. You cannot erase that.
It's a sexual violence in a form, one form of sexual violence, and a child has a right to live a healthy life, which you're taking it away from her by doing this. And there have been repercussions. People have been having problems post this. There have been bleeding and a lot of other infections and things like that, because it was done in a crude way. But even if it's not done in a crude way, today people will justify saying that it's done very hygienically in hospitals and under whatever conditions. But that does not justify a child's rights. You're taking away a child's rights, you know.
I blamed my mother, I don't know why. I did not blame my grandmother, because I trusted my mother more than my grandmother. For me, I do not believe in Khatna because my sexuality do not need any moderation.